ओके स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम चैप्टर ऑफ आईसीएसई क्लास 10 बायोलॉजी। दिस इज़ द पार्ट 3 ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। इन द प्रीवियस पार्ट वी स्टडीड अबाउट द एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स, मीन्स द एड्रिनल ग्लैंड विच इज़ प्रेजेंट इन आवर बॉडी। इन दिस पार्ट वी विल स्टडी अबाउट अनदर एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड विच इज़ प्रेजेंट इन आवर बॉडी, दैट इज पैनक्रियस। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। So before starting pancreas, I want to tell you something that when I started this chapter, I told about the endocrine gland that it is a ductless gland. Okay, means it do not need any special kind of duct for the transport of its hormones. Its secretions are directly poured into the blood. But there is one more gland which is known as the exocrine gland. Okay, so what are these exocrine glands? Exocrine glands are those glands which have a special duct for its secretion to travel. Okay, means this type of glands have a special duct for its secretions. They do not pour their secretion directly into the blood. So as in case of pancreas, it is both an endocrine as well as an exocrine gland. As an exocrine gland, its secretion is poured into the duodenum. Now here it is the location of pancreas. You can see in the human body, if you will zoom it here, this is the pancreas and this is the pancreatic duct. Okay, so as I told you, exocrine gland needs a duct for its secretion to be poured. This is the duodenum. So pancreas, what it does, its secretion travels through this duct and reaches the duodenum. So this is the main function of it as an exocrine gland. And as an endocrine gland, it has certain hormone secreting cells. Pancreas has certain cells which secrete hormones called islets of Langerhans. So the name of those cells is islets of Langerhans. This is very, very important. You need to remember this. It has three types of cells. So islet of Langerhans is a group of cells. It has three types, namely beta, alpha and delta, out of which delta is not in your syllabus. So we will study about these two types of cells, that is alpha and beta. So beta cells secrete a hormone called insulin and alpha cells secrete a hormone called glucagon. Okay, so we will study this in detail. So what is insulin? Insulin is the hormone which is secreted from the beta cells. Here you can see this is the pancreas and these are those cells which secrete hormones. Now what is the function of this insulin? Insulin checks the rise in sugar level in the blood. What happens when the sugar level in our blood increases? So this hormone is secreted so as to maintain the sugar level. Okay, what it does, it stimulates the deposition of glucose as glycogen in the liver. Whenever there is a rise in the glucose level in the blood, it stimulates those glucose to deposit in the liver in the form of glycogen. Okay, as a level of which the glucose level will decrease, secreted from the beta cells. So these hormones are secreted from the beta. Now what happens when it is hyposecreted and hypersecreted? Hyposecreted means what? Whenever there is a deficiency of insulin. So when there is a deficiency of insulin, what will happen? The glucose level in the blood will increase, as a result of which there is a condition called hyperglycemia. Hyperglycemia means diabetes mellitus. It is the increase in the glucose level in the blood due to insufficient insulin. Okay, so what will happen in this condition? The urine will contain a lot of sugar, there will be loss of weight. And what will happen when it is hypersecreted? Hypersecretion means when it is secreted in excess. Okay, in excess. So when it is secreted in excess, it causes a condition called hypoglycemia. Hypoglycemia means the blood sugar level will decrease, will fall down, as a result of which a person can get into a state of coma. Okay, so this was the hypersecretion, hyposecretion and the function of insulin. Another hormone is the glucagon. Glucagon is secreted from the alpha cells. Its function is the reverse of the function of insulin. Insulin checks the glucose level in the blood. It raises the sugar level in the blood. Means when there is a low blood sugar level, glucagon is secreted so as to raise the sugar level. What it does? It stimulates the breakdown of glycogen. As we know that glucose is stored, means glucose get deposited in the liver to form glycogen. So glycogen is break down by the hormone called glucagon to release the glucose. Okay, so this was the function of glucagon. So the last is endocrine and exocrine difference. As I told you, exocrine gland is another type of gland which need a kind of duct for its secretion to be poured into the target organ. So first difference is secretes hormones. Endocrine glands generally secrete hormones. Exocrine gland secretes enzyme and other substance. So exocrine gland secrete enzyme. Enzyme is another kind of you can say compound which is secreted by the exocrine gland, and other substance include like sweat. Okay, see, these all needs an exocrine gland. They are the ductless glands. They do not have a special duct. They have a duct for its secretion. Example of endocrine glands: adrenal gland, thyroid gland. And example of exocrine glands: sweat glands. And also one more thing, it is also called a mixed gland. Okay, because it is both endocrine as well as exocrine. So this was our pancreas. We studied about the hormones secreted from pancreas, what are its function. If you like my video, subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. We will meet in the next video.